It all started out with 10 teams and we are down to 4. Good evening, magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. It is PFF Women's League 2023 action as we come to you dito po sa historic Rizal Memorial Stadium. This is Claro Manzano on call for this match and we are glad to have you on board. Maraming salamat po sa inyong suporta as you are catching this on the Facebook and YouTube pages ng ating Philippine Football Federation Women's League. Paki-like, share at subscribe na lang po and we are glad to have you on board again for this second semifinal match right here. We've got the first seed Kaya FC Iloilo and the number 4 squad in De La Salle University as we take it to the starting lineups. First and foremost with Kaya FC, they've got their mainstays back in terms of national team players Ina Palacios and Haley Long. And we look at their squad actually, a great number of them used to play in the collegiate ranks, particularly in the UAAP. And they are bannered by their head coach in Let Dimzon, herself a former women's national team player, as we will zoom in further on a player to look out for dito po sa Kaya FC. And it's got to be Haley Long. And Long, of course, as we know, a Filipinas mainstay or Philippine women's national team defender. And she has about 80 appearances already and is one of the captains of the squad. And if they want to get going, they have to be solid in defense so they could get in their attack in confidence, as we will carry on to De La Salle University, the Lady Archers as they are known. And there we go, another experienced head coach in Alvin Ocampo, and the tandem of Coach Ocampo and Coach Hans Smith, of course, is something we have seen through over a very long time, and they've been able to produce a great number of players, some of them already playing in Kaya FC as they have exhausted their UAAP eligibility, that is in the collegiate or university ranks. And they of course will be bannered by Laika Tevez, who is their main person in the attack. Of course, she is the reigning best striker or top scorer in the UAP, as we saw last season. But they are out for more because they only fell or settled for second place as they lost through a late goal to Far Eastern University. That's a team we will get to later on. Alongside Tevez, of course, is Shai Del Campo, a rookie of the year in the collegiate ranks also, and is fresh off a women's national team stint. So it is your chance, of course, to see the players of the women's national team continue to slug it out right here in the local stages, as we are close already to taking it to the pitch for the pre-match walk-in. Again, it is Kaya FC Iloilo and the De La Salle University Lady Archers. It is the semifinals of the PFF Women's League 2023. just gotta love it when you hear the FIFA Living Football anthem as players took it to the field already, and we are close to wrapping up pre-match protocols already. At ang ating team captains po dito ngayon ay si Bebe Lemoran for Kaya FC Iloilo, and we've got veteran Bea De Los Reyes of De La Salle University. At kita natin dun ang ating match officials. Si KB Nanyola ay ang referee, si Analu Arrogante and Adrian Gumtang ay ang assistant referees. Sila po ang in charge sa offside. Ang court official ay si Timothy De Castro, at si Merly Asibar ay ang referee assessor. Last but not the least, si Mark Ian Baldopo ay ang ating match commissioner. And this is Clara Manzano on call for this match. Will it be Una Kaya or Animo La Salle this evening? It is your Saturday night to kick off your football action. So simple as is, it is a winner-take-all affair. We will need to have a winner in this match. Should we be tied after 90 minutes, we will proceed to extra time if necessary, where we will have two 15-minute halves. Should we be tied after extra time, we will head on to the dreaded penalty shootout, which could go either way. So teams running through their final huddles, and we look at their previous encounter when we refer to Kaya FC Iloilo and De La Salle University. We get to see in our records that Kaya did take a 2-1 victory over La Salle. The likes of Kadag and Ramores found the back of the net in the first half, and that was enough for Kaya to take the victory. But there was the likes of Megan Alforque who found the back of the net to spoil the clean sheet. And we did see, of course, it was a closely fought match. Kaya did not have the likes of national team mainstays in Ina Palacios and Haley Long, but that is just a testament, of course, to the depth of the squad of Coach Let Dimzon. De La Salle using this competition as part of their build-up for the University Athletic Association of the Philippines football tournament. Well, for Kaya, this is their main competition. A number of former Lady Archers are in this Kaya squad again. And as we mentioned, the likes of Coach Alvin Ocampo, he'd say that it will be a tough matchup given that, or he is aware of all their strengths. Coach Hans Smith, on the other hand, is just focused on this game. And he did say, or is pleased to see, that he has former players who are continuing to pursue the sport of football. So the likes of Shella Kadag to kick off this match, and we are off. Kaya FC Iloilo are in their black uniforms with yellow trim. De La Salle University are in their white shirts, green shorts, and they are currently with possession now, trying to secure it. It is under contest for the moment, but here's a chance now. Kita natin traffic sa midfield, pero binigay dito sa kaliwa. The likes of Toledo. Toledo squaring off with Julieza. And it looks like we have our first foul of the match. It will be a free kick from the left. Kaya did start out with possession, but La Salle just swarmed them. And they get to carve out this chance. Kanino po kayo dito, Kaya o La Salle? Pakilagay na lang sa comment section. As Toledo will step up to the plate. Whips this ball in. And that was on target, but definitely not a problem at all for the veteran in Ina Palacios. Palacios with 50 appearances plus for the Philippines, as it is with the skipper now, Nakay Lemoran. And they gave it through. Kadag takes it, and it's off the post. Everyone there holding on to their seats. And Rodriguez just sends this out and about, trying to go for the volley given that she found herself in a great position. Both teams starting out strong, already knocking on the door. What effort here to keep that energy going. And a great service from Navaja. So De Los Reyes got dispossessed. May throw in ang LaSalle. It looks like this will have to be retaken. De Los Reyes deemed to have gotten an advantage walking down the sideline. But it's now to the back. So we did mention, of course, the players to look out for. And for LaSalle, it is Laika Tevez. If she wants to score, she will have to get past Haley Long. Of course, a person with World Cup experience just months back. Of course, a milestone year for Philippine football with the women's national team advancing to the World Cup. So kung may hangover po kayo doon, dito tayo, of course. Your Filipinas are actually catching action here with their respective schools or clubs. So a throw in on the other side for the Lady Archers. LaSalle in that 4-4-2 formation. Kaya, on the other hand, with this 4-3-3. The 4-4-2, a balanced formation that can allow teams, of course, to, or which can be utilized for defense or attack. Kaya opting for the 4-3-3, more of an attacking-oriented formation. Let's see which style and which game plan will prevail, as this was cleared initially. That was by Analu Amita. Amita, of course, with, or the sister of Nano Amita. The Amitas, of course, well known in the football scene. Looks like Navajo whipped it to the middle, but it was secured by LaSalle in white again. As they're trying to get forward now, Kadag trying to connect with Navaja. But this one sent down the line. Haley Long didn't get a great first touch now. Looks like Tevez got it. Palacios, though, did just enough to get that out of target. But great work from Tevez. Day in and day out, of course, Tevez. A player who looked to find the back of the net. As a result, of course, there's that corner kick. So this will be an in-swinger, courtesy of Toledo. Bodies in the area, who will prevail? And it's whipped into the near post. Sent over to the side, Rodriguez to chase, but the flag is up. And it will return to Kaya FC. So here we go now, it was sent back. Picked up by Palacios. You see the confidence, of course, of Kaya in their keeper. And here comes Long. They'll try to initiate plays from the back. Palacios, binigay kay Amita. Over the further end, Navaja, nagmamadali. Trying to play it through again to Kadag. Safety first, according to the LaSalle backline. A great initiative there from Kaya, continuing their attack. But it was gifted away. But you see Kaya making the transition difficult for LaSalle as they launch this one forward again. And it's Long versus Tevez, that matchup that we were referring to. Long, of course, much bigger and experienced. Tevez, the speedier player. Lemoran gave it again Kaya as of late favoring the left. They find Rodriguez. Denied by the Lady Archers, but you can still say it's mission accomplished for Kaya. Kaya overloading the left, and they were giving, and they just found a space on the right. Julieza, diagonal ball, took a bounce. Kadag, still with it, but denied by Bing Humawan. Lemoran, tried to thread the needle in. Sent to the middle. Still under dispute, but Kaya prevail. Hazel Lustan with a tremendous effort now. Rodriguez bumping bodies with Delos Reyes. Legal contact from the looks of it. And it stays with Kaya FC. LaSalle hustling hard on defense to make it difficult for their counterparts. So throw and taken. Julieza. This looping ball. The keeper unable to secure it and eventually does. And it is into the gloves of Jessica Pido. She's had the nod as of late here for DLSU. LaSalle finishing fourth again, that with 19 points. They picked up 6 wins, 1 draw, and 2 losses. Kaya, on the other hand, with identical 7 wins, 1 draw, and a 1 loss card, along with number 2 and 3, FU and Manila Digger. It was goal difference that allowed Kaya to prevail and take the top seed. Rodriguez pa rin. Send it out wide, pero mukhang offside ang ating tawag dito. Perhaps the timing could get some fine tuning in that aspect, but you do like the fact that you are holding on to possession and getting forward for Kaya. Now the Lady Archers will try to take a roll of the dice. And you also see, of course, the trust of LaSalle in their back line. It is essential in the modern day for goalkeepers to get involved and to be good with their feet. As they try to connect on the switch now. Still up for grabs. The ball ping-ponging off. I believe Long got a touch. It's now with Amita. We've also seen her play wing throughout the course of her career. But that speed has allowed her, of course, to find a place in that left-back position. So it will be a throw-in to resume this game. And when we look at the top scorer category, or the Golden Boot race, as there's this through ball, but it is overcooked. It is Isabella Bandoha of Tuloy, who is currently on top of the table with a whopping 19 goals. At kilala na natin yung second place sa ngayon, si Angelica Teves ng DLSU, 17 to her name. And then there is Inday Tolentin with 14. As Rodriguez gets this now, still trying to hold on now. Looking for a teammate. Just whipped it in. Picked up by the keeper. So in terms of scorers here for Kaya, no player in the top three, but right below is Shela Kadag with 10 and Camille Rodriguez with 7. Hazel Lustan with 6. Kaya finding goal scorers throughout their entire roster. LaSalle, on the other hand, behind Tevez, you have the 5 goals of Shai Del Campo, this PFF Women's League. As Jessica Pido will get this back underway. They have to play it short. But here are the probing runs. And it looks like it was Autumn who tried to round her counterpart, but it went out of play. Throw in dito para sa Kaya FC Iloilo. Now Now it's under dispute. Haley Long trying to join the attack. Didn't get to secure it. The Lady Archers working their way through. And they eventually launch this. Redwell by Beluga. Amita got it to Kadag from the looks of it. Julieza, Kai Rodriguez. Lemuran, the former UST player. But this ball played forward and picked up. Pido will try to kill some of that momentum. And again, we did mention these two teams are quite familiar with one another. As this is cleared by Julieza. Autumn just sending it the other way. At nakay Amita ngayon. Haley Long. Kaya missing the services of Haley Long and Ina Palacios for a stretch in the elimination round. But their players got to step up well. And they definitely got to secure the top seed. But it's all to play for now. It's about winning the semifinal match. The winner will get to face Manila Digger in the finals, which will take place on November 8th dito po rin ulit sa Rizal Memorial Stadium. And we invite you to join us here and catch the action live. Del Campo is letting it roll out of play. Del Campo, one of the veteran players of La Salle, fresh also off that Asian Games stint wherein the Philippines booked a historic quarterfinals ticket. Rodriguez now. Pero kita nga natin traffic dito. Ito sent in. Still picked up well though. Ito Santiago was hustling hard here. Things getting quite chippy with the two squads. We've had some throw-ins, of course, with that stop and start nature of the game. So also on November 8th, the loser of this match will square off with Far Eastern University in the battle for third. As Del Campo is trying to round traffic, I think he took a hit in the face there, but saw that coming. And what a move now. La Salle storming forward, trying to play Tevez. Tevez contra Long. They've been going for it throughout the course of this game. And you see the furious Toledo. Thinking that it should have gone their way. Toledo did well to find Tevez in that situation. And what more for Tevez with this opportunity to gain experience up against a formidable defender in Haley Long. As this was read well by Autumn. Now how will they transition to the attack? Tevez, but just swarmed there. Great effort from Hazel Lustan. Lustan to Rodriguez. Rodriguez trying to play it forward. And denied again by Pido. This volley read well though, Lemoran. When we look at this Kaya squad, they're composed of former UST, FEU, and La Salle players. Lemoran running into traffic now, and La Salle trying to unleash on the counter. Del Campo did well to evade the charging Haley Long, but no teammate up front. They were not on the same page. Looks like Lustan got dispossessed. Now played back, De Los Reyes. And that whistle is eventually, or that foul is eventually called. And of course, don't you forget to let us know in the comments. Is it Una Kaya or Animo La Salle? Kaya FC Iloilo in their black uniforms with yellow trim. We've got La Salle, the De La Salle University Lady Archers in their white and green. As this is calmly picked up by Palacios. And what a rocket of an arm there. Eventually secured by Navaja. Navaja and Palacios, teammates when they picked up a collegiate title. Biluga playing in the center back position alongside Haley Long. We've also seen her play fullback, especially in the PFF Women's Cup. Lemoran. Lustan. Taken from distance, but it is off target. So the Lady Archers to get this back into play with a goal kick. And when we assess their statistics, Kaya forwarding or scoring 42 goals in 9 games in the elimination round. And they conceded 6. Good for a goal difference of plus 36. Kaya statistically with the best offense and second best defense. La Salle on the other hand scoring 30 goals and letting in 11 as they play this one through now on the left to Layakan. One of those mainstays on the wing. Try to cut it back, but read well by Long. Layakan is down now, but there's Tevez. Sends it in. It's 1-0. Sensational finish from the reigning top scorer in the UAAP. The Lady Archers starting or getting the lead in style. Layakan, her hard work paying off eventually. And there was the likes of Del Campo. Tevez just sending that past Palacios. Layakan getting it into the danger area. Del Campo there with the press to dispossess or get that away from Kaya and Haley Long. Tevez, of course, knew what to do without a doubt. She knew the drill. And Angelica Tevez now with 18 goals to her name. And that is in 10 games. One goal shy from Bandoja, the top scorer this tournament. Now let's see how Kaya will respond. Teams, of course, can get most vulnerable after scoring a goal. Let's see if Kaya will get that sense of urgency injected into their game. We got a loose touch from Rodriguez. But nonetheless, this surrenders possession to La Salle. But a chance to press their counterparts in. Possibly get a goal out of their hard work up front. De Los Reyes give it to the middle to Humawan. Some nervy moments there, but some calm footwork. But De Los Reyes just had to succumb to that press or pressure. The cross from Lemoran. Relatively half cleared. For those who just tuned in, the LSU, or the Lady Archers, took a 1-0 lead in the 19th minute behind their lead scorer in Laika Tevez. Lemoran trying to whip this in and easily collected by Pido. Now a chance to get things going their way. Definitely the Lasallians would like to pick up an insurance goal, especially now that they're facing, or especially with them facing, a powerhouse team in Kaya. As Layakan was dispossessed by Haley Long, Rodriguez gave it to the middle. Lemoran, Lustan, you have that duo playing in the center of midfield for Kaya. That duo, of course. The likes of Lustan and Lemoran completed their studies at the University of Santo Tomas. They got to suit up and gain experience under Coach Aging. Under Coach Aging. Rodriguez playing it back. Long. Naghanap ng kakampi. Trying to lob it. This one going out. Pero outside ang tawag dito. Last touch po ang kaya FC Iloilo. And of course, we want to give a shout out to the teams here competing or just finished competing in the PFF Women's League 2023. Other than Kaya and the LSU, we have FEU set to play the loser of this match in November in the battle for third. Manila Digger will play in the final in their debut season, of course, which they can end, which they would like to end strong and on a good note. So Kai escaping the pressure there. But there was Layakan up to bother the charging Julieza, who will secure us this ping pongs. So again, as we continue to shout out the participating teams here, finishing fifth, we have Tuloy FC, followed by Nomads, the University of the Philippines, the University of Santo Tomas, Azuri, and Stallion Laguna FC to wrap up the 10-team field. We also got to see Chandler and Olivia McDaniel suit up in one match again for Stallion Laguna. And by coincidence, they squared off with De La Salle as Del Campo couldn't find a teammate there. And Moran. So you see those motions from Kaya in their offense. They get those combinations working. It was that tough stretch in defense that allowed De La Salle to find the back of the net. As it is with Palacios. Gave it over to Long. Tevez, of course, had goal number two in mind. Ramore secured it and got it to Amita. Navaja, it stays with them. Playing it quickly now. We've been seeing that initiative from Kaya trying to catch the LSU quickly on the throw-in. No goals to show yet in this young match. So LaSalle got to find the back of the net. And now their defense continuously being tested by the experienced Kaya Iloilo. Will they at least hold on as we saw Haley Long get into a collision with Tevez from the looks of it? Sorry, I'll have to check that and clarify. As it was not Tevez who was close to Haley. And we just saw that happen once more. Long taking a fall. And it looks like our referee, KB Nanyola, will have a chat with our linesman. And this brief stoppage could just possibly stun the momentum that Kaya have been able to pick up. And we are seeing some warnings being issued from the looks of it. They're having a quick word. There's Camilo Rodriguez and referee KB Nanyola. And it's eventually all systems go. Kaya with the corner. Will they make it count? It's still in the middle of the box. Sent to relative safety. Layakan storming through. Meliuga did just enough. A non-ideal touch, though, from the looks of it. And they foul again, going Kaya's way. About two shots taken already for Iloilo so far in this match, as opposed to the three from La Salle. Out of the two shots of Kaya, none of them have been on target as of late, but their services have been picked up by the keeper. And there you go. They get this one on target, but not enough to trouble Pido. So close to the half-hour mark already of this match. It's been mainly Kaya on the attack, but La Salle have been able to make their scoring or attacking waves count. It's been a busy midfield here. Both teams just going for it. It's all to play for again. The winner will book the final ticket or the remaining ticket to the final. Taken down the line by Julieza. Kaya FC Iloilo again in their black uniforms with yellow trim. Ang La Salle naman ay nakaputi at green. Julieza will try to switch it up or send in an early cross rather. Long. Now well secured by La Salle. But here's Ramores trying to choke that La Salle midfield. De Los Reyes. Del Campo couldn't get to it. No, and earlier we did get to see Danioso try to get the ball up with their individual skill. One player, of course, who's been able to contribute greatly to this effort of DLSU. But again, the test will continue. Kaya responding after La Salle taking a 1-0 lead behind Laika Tevez in the 19th minute. Still no goal to show. But this game definitely young again, just about 30 minutes in. As the ball ping-pongs around, a shove from Rodriguez. And it's a whistle in favor of La Salle. Great sportsmanship there, sending her apologies. Definitely trying to play for the ball. And it was Danioso who won that foul for them. But here comes Kaya again. That's been the script as of late. Autumn is scrambling to secure it. And that's exactly what she does. Autumn pa rin. Keeps it in. No teammate forward though. And it was eventually intercepted by Beluga. Long with the clearance. Ramores, great individual skill. Julieza. They'll try to sort themselves out here. They gave it to Palacios, who in turn sends it back. Both teams coming off wins again to seal their respective spots in the semifinals. DLSU defeated Nomads 1-0 to secure the fourth and final ticket again to the semis. As this dangerous ball was picked up by Pido. Found Layakan with the open space. Del Campo was there to support, squaring off with Lustan. Budikaya midfield eventually recovering. Lemoran, Amita. Beluga. La Salle again with the 4-4-2 formation. And so far, it's so far so good for them. Kaya with the more attacking-minded 4-3-3. And the chance now to get forward. De Los Reyes approaching her final UAAP season. Coach Alvin Ocampo trying to drive them forward and stretch out the opposing defense. Coach Alvin Ocampo, of course, a man who was associated with Kaya back in the day. Tevez, this was poked away, but it stays with them. And of course, when we look at the local football scene, a congratulations again to the U17 Filipinas for sealing a ticket in the Asian Cup. And of course, the senior women's national team, the Filipinas, getting a quarterfinal finish in the Asian Games, a historic feat. And later on this month, huwag niyo kalimutan po, may round 2 ng Olympic qualifiers. The Philippines will be traveling to Australia to figure in a 14 group stage. As Palacios picked this up. Great distribution. Let's see how Kaya will try to get this going. But it's no good to Shelakadag, their number 2 leading scorer. Or their leading scorer, in fact. 10 goals and counting so far this season. Looks like there was a hit there. But Kai continuing to play on. I'll try to confirm who was downed. But currently off camera now. The switch just rattled off a Lasalle defender and eventually picked up by Jessica Pidot with play stopped. Let's try to get a closer look on who is down. And it is Mindanyo from the looks of it. That is confirmed. Mindanyo getting hit while storming forward. I believe it was a hit to the face. But it's great to see, of course, that she is okay and will definitely be able to continue. Shout out, siyempre, sa bouncer natin, si Kuya Al. Man on the ground, of course. A drop ball to resume things. 11 minutes until additional time in the first half. Laika Tevez again with the lone goal of the match. And DLSU currently with the initiative. A slim 1-0 lead. Will it be enough? Mindanyo now, getting through the middle. It's promising ball into the area, but there was long to make the interception and deny Toledo. Long over to Navaja, but an unideal touch. Danioso swung it over. De Los Reyes. Layakan versus Rodriguez. Leakan managed to get it back. Danioso sent it back here. De Los Reyes, their team captain, asking for options. Couldn't find Tevez. At nandito na ngayon kay Beluga. Long. And you see some pressure, of course, from the right side, courtesy of Toledo. Toledo getting whistled for the foul. Looks like Shai Del Campo wasn't happy with that call. Having a chat with our referee. And there was the call. You be the judge. Ramores. Kadag. Keeper off her line. Eventually picks it up to deny the goal scoring opportunity. It's Pido. Has been the busier keeper as of late, we could say. What worked from Amita. Kaya getting forward now. Kadag to Navaja. Navaja, this ball to Rodriguez. Rodriguez! But it is no good and off target again. But Kaya slowly growing into this match. 4 shots taken already in this game. LaSalle will try to build this one up from the back. And in that semi or the other side of the bracket, we did see Manila Digger defeat FEU 4-3 on penalties. They were tied 0-0 after regulation and extra time. And we had to head over, of course, to the penalty shootouts, or which is a lottery. De Los Reyes got past Rodriguez, but unable to find Layakan there. Tevez with the right intentions, though. Some fine-tuning can work wonders for them. LaSalle again using the PFF Women's League as part of their build-up for the UAAP. The tournament, of course, for universities in Metro Manila. And what more, LaSalle with this chance to square off with former UAP players who were standouts, of course, in their own right. Kaya with this studded squad, we could say, with great accolades. As Amita gets it to Kadag, takes a shot, but it sails just over the bar. Close, but not quite. You can see or feel the tension and anticipation in the stands. Pidot now opting to play it to the right, which is the further end now from our camera angle. Del Campo. Del Campo almost succeeding there. Lustan. Ramores. Navaja. Thought about it for a moment. Got it past Autumn. Looks like there's some shoving there. Navaja again hitting a LaSallean though. And the chance to pounce on the counter. Their numbers back though, have as they had to defend this one. They clearly respect this Kaya attack. Del Campo with space to operate. Numbers out to clamp her down. Beluga with that great effort. Let's see how they'll be able to utilize this spark. The unsuccessful slide. Ramores. Binalik kay Navaja. Amita, who's been very active in this game. Bebele Moran getting dispossessed. And Mendaño's attempt to get forward, just getting delayed. So again, when we look at their previous results as they close the elimination round, DLSU sealed their semifinal ticket with a 1-0 victory over Nomads. Kaya, on the other hand, did have to play for seeding despite sealing their semifinal ticket, and they cruised to victory in style with a 15-0 victory over Stallion Laguna FC, with Camille Rodriguez providing 4 goals. Referee opted to play advantage there. This one up for the chase. Beluga contra Layakan. Layakan so far so good. Getting tripped. Referee said this one is clean. And it is a corner kick. Second corner of the game here for DLSU. You see Layakan pictured, of course. That effort moving forward gives LaSalle this set piece. A chance to double their lead now. Kaya getting all numbers, all field players well within the half line. But LaSalle with the chance. But they'll have to be wary. Kaya just ready to unleash on the counter. It's set to be an in-swinger. Driven in, going for the further post. Haley Long was up to that. Long just sending it to safety. And that was a promising corner from Toledo. And a good evening, of course, to all of our viewers. Paki-like, share, at subscribe na lang po rito. And continue to support local football. Will it be Una Kaya or Animo Lasal? Pakilagay na lang sa comment section. And we apologize for any technical difficulties with our timer. So as of late it is, or as of now, it is 42 minutes and 34 seconds. This match, without a doubt, still up for grabs. You can feel the intensity picking up as this is the semifinals. LaSalle mainly pouncing on the counter. Their hard work forced an error from the Kaya back line, and Steves found the back of the net. Steves getting forward, the cross, Del Campo! Taking a bounce, but it is off target. Del Campo came close to sealing or getting international caps with the Filipinas in the 2022 AFF Women's Championship that took place right here in the Rizal Memorial Stadium, but was hobbled by a foot injury. She definitely stayed sharp and was a mainstay for LaSalle in their previous UAP tournament. As Rodriguez gets this, plays it out wide to Jolieza. Sends it, but definitely not a problem for Pido. So far, so good for her. And has been stable in this game. You definitely need the confidence from your goalkeeper as you'd like to get numbers forward. Del Campo again getting it. Getting it over to Toledo. Toledo versus Amita. Tevez, but denied by Palacios. Lemoran. This game opening up quite a bit. But sadly, Rodriguez is unable to keep this in for Kaya. But of course, if you are Kaya FC Iloilo, you eventually have the halftime break to rest and recover, as we have 2 minutes of additional time, as confirmed by our fourth official, Timothy De Castro, on the ground. If you are LaSalle, though, you'd like to address those chinks in the armor and at least try to get one more goal. Long taking a fall, but eventually we have a whistle from the referee. 30 seconds, or just 30 seconds into additional time. Looks like this one was blocked though, but nonetheless, Palacios was there at the back to get it. As this ball will ping pong around, secured by De Los Reyes. There was the shove from Jolieza, but no call by the referee. This one over the top, Kadag, the keeper to beat. Pido is up to this one. Rodriguez getting to deny the De Los Reyes pass. At least if you are Kaya FC, you will need to do damage control. Just head into the locker room with this scoreline. And they succeed here. LaSalle were struggling in that spell. As it's going back and forth now, they found the likes of Del Campo and her teammate in the midfield, Danioso. Danioso, of course, combining well with teammates in this match. Amita Navaja. Got past one. Couldn't make it two. Lamoran from distance on target. But collected by the keeper once more as we have the halftime whistle right there, ladies and gentlemen. It is Kaya FC Iloilo 0 and the De La Salle University Lady Archers 1 behind the 19th minute. The strike from Laika Tevez in the 19th minute as we will head over to the halftime break and we'll catch you in a bit. close to concluding this halftime break, or the halftime break right here in the semifinals of the PFF Women's League 2023. We've got Kaya FC Iloilo nil as we speak, with De La Salle University with a slim one goal lead. Laika Tevez finding the back of the net and possession favoring Kaya, but they still haven't been able to find the back of the net. But the shots are there, the chances are there, as Jessica Pido has been stable and composed in this match. Shots on target 4-3 with corners just slightly favoring La Salle, with teams getting quite a number of fouls in this one. As we'll check that, it is 5 fouls for DLSU and 4 fouls for Kaya FC Iloilo. With Kaya, it's just a correction, getting flagged once for offside in this match. No cards to show in this game, as players, of course, have been able to stay calm and collected so far, as teams are taking it to the pitch already and have been able to wrap up their respective halftime huddles at the locker room. Coach Letdimzon, of course, keen on sorting this out, as they would like to at least equalize and extend this game. But knowing their stacked roster with great number of attacking options, they do have the potential to test the LaSalle defense and potentially put in more than one goal. LaSalle, on the other hand, the same could be said with their up-and-coming players who are on the bench, given that they are a collegiate side. But it looks like we will have no changes or substitutions at the halftime break, as Kaya out to head to their 4-3-3 formation. And again, we are talking about Kaya looking to spark their offense here in hopes of sealing a ticket to the finals. La Salle, on the other hand, 1 foot already on that ticket, and they'd love to at least defend this lead and carry on that hard-nosed defense that has been continuously tested and bombarded by this Kaya squad, with a great number of former UAAP players, particularly from the likes of UST, DLSU, and FEU. There's Laika Tevez with 18 goals and counting already in this campaign. Thanks to her goal earlier, she is now one goal shy from leading scorer Isabella Bandoja. And Tevez, of course, a proven attacker, as she was the best striker in the previous UAAP season that ended about June this year. So Kaya now with the initiative. The possession there, of course, just that fine-tuning in the attacking third. They've been able to do just enough in the midfield. If they could also find that fifth gear in the midfield, they'll be well poised to get scoring opportunities. For La Salle, of course, they are definitely one of the top university sides here in the country. And there's Del Campo squaring off with Amita. And what work right there from Danioso. Danioso pa rin. Not the best of deliveries, though. But Beluga could not secure it. So they get it forward. Del Campo contra Lemoran. Got past one, couldn't make it two. So De La Salle University again in their white tops, green shorts, and green stockings. Kaya FC Iloilo are in their black uniforms with yellow trim, with white socks. Kaya playing from right to left, currently defending. La Salle, of course, attacking. Now behind the likes of Laika Tevez. They are playing from left to right, as there's a foul there to send traffic going in Kaya's way.
So semifinal action again here in the PFF Women's League 2023. And you are catching this on the Facebook and YouTube pages of the PFF Women's League and the Philippine Football Federation. Dito naman tayo sa comment section sa YouTube stream. And thank you again for supporting local football. And of course, congratulations again to the U17 Filipinas for qualifying to the Asian Cup. And let's not forget that the Filipinas picked up that historic quarterfinal finish in the recently concluded Asian Games football tournament. Later this month, the women's national team again, the senior national team, will head to Australia to take part in the Olympic qualifiers as they cut this back and they find the back of the net. Kadag rising up to the occasion, and that looked like an assist from Rodriguez executing their plan out of the dugout to perfection. Just 3-4 minutes into the game and we're back into this one. Rodriguez, her hard work paying off. Kadag there to tap it in. Calm as ever. Kadag now with her 11th goal of this tournament. And unfortunately, LaSalle will have to, or there is no clean sheet for LaSalle. And they'll relinquish their lead. Tanyoso took a fall. The referee took no interest there. Kaya now working their way up. Kadag just brewing with confidence. Rodriguez playing narrow. Got past one. Made it two. Got it again. Rodriguez inside. Took a fall, but no call from the referee. But is down in pain. Danioso was there to make the challenge and sends her apologies. But was so close to getting another shot in frame. Well, there was just Danioso. He's playing hard to get the last ditch denial. So you could say we're back to where we started. Both teams on level terms, but definitely no more clean sheet. Shalakadag's goal canceling out the effort of Laika Tevez. And Autumn will send us down the line. Now it's into the middle. Kadag just sent it forward for safety. And here's Ramores. Navaja. The loose touch. Traffic in the middle. It goes to Kaya now. Lustan was going for the open space. Great intentions, but there was Layakan to change it up. De Los Reyes. Both number 10s going for it. Layakan contra Lustan. And gets it now. Layakan playing it through. Long eventually got it as Analu Amita got the interception. Navaja just denied though. Haley Long having to track down. She does have that license from Coach Let Dimzon to join the attacking effort despite being the center back. As we have a player down from what appears to be cramps or and strained herself in the process. Great sportsmanship from Irish Navaja. Navaja, of course, a former player for LaSalle herself. So it is Autumn who is down. But from the looks of it, no players warming up yet for LaSalle. So Toledo will put this back into play. Ramores. We've just seen everyone here from DLSU and Kaya just give 110%. Everyone making an impact in the midfield, trying to get one over the other. Rodriguez inside the area. Sends it in, denied initially. Sent to safety, Lemoran. Tried to go for it, but it sails over the bar again. And it's great to see, of course, fans coming into the stadium to catch their Saturday night action of the PFF Women's League 2023. And we're glad to have you on board for this one. It is De La Salle University, the Lady Archers, squaring off with Kaya FC Iloilo in the semifinals again. This is a winner-take-all match. The victor will square off with Manila Digger FC in the finals on November 8th. The loser will be relegated to the battle for third between with Far Eastern University. Palacios. Gave it over to Long. Two tenured players, of course, for the Filipinas. But intercepted well. And it will stay with La Salle. Teams, of course, is trying to get in the trying to stun the other's momentum. Whether it be coming up with fouls or sending the ball out of play for a throw-in. The collision there not warranting a whistle. And they got it over to Navaja. Navaja with space to operate. Got into the middle now with Lustan. Amita tried to find Kadag. Lemoran. A promising spell from Kaya. This rattled around though. De Los Reyes contra Rodriguez. Rodriguez, of course, stepping up the intensity in this second half. And was credited with the assist to Shalakadag. As they were close to finding a teammate here in Samantha Toledo when we refer to La Salle. The pace in the second half settling once more. And it has been a similar flow to the first half. The LSU trying to make their magic work in transition. Kaya FC playing that possession game. Kadag now. Couldn't go for Ramores. And they'll play this one long on the counter. Toledo nagmamadali contra Amita. Speaking of the Amita family, shout out sa idol natin, si Nano Amita, the supportive brother of Analu. Nano Amita, of course, with the men's team of Kaya FC Iloilo. The Amita family from Davao de Oro. Now, this one relatively under dispute. Navaja. Finds herself in a tight space, though. And there's a whistle. And there was Mendanya who got decked. And it looks like she got to make the most of that, but is definitely winded from the intensity of this game. And here's what went on. Of course, Navaja, an older sister to these Lady Archers. Trying to teach them a lesson or two. But sadly they give up that foul. And they whip it in. The loose ball, Layakan trying to secure. And that's what she manages to do. Layakan contra Julieza. De Los Reyes. Dispossessed though by Lemoran. But De Los Reyes just fighting back. But it's in the midfield. Who will secure? Shout out din kay Kuya Miles. Good evening and thank you for tuning in. And whose side are you on here? Is it Kaya FC Iloilo or De La Salle University? Is it Una Kaya or Animo La Salle? And this is Clara Manzano, your commentator on call for this match. And we're glad to have you on board in what is set to be an action-packed weekend for Philippine football, or an action-packed month, mind you. As you could check the Facebook page of the Philippine Football Federation for what we have in store. We also have the Tri-Nations Futsal Tournament set to take place just right beside us at the Ninoy Aquino Stadium. That is later this month. Do give us a follow on social media. And this one in the middle, Rodriguez. Playing in the middle, not her usual wing spot. As here's Navaja, who's been playing narrow as of late. Oh, two. Just getting this to open space. Masala as of late trying to go for Toledo on the right wing. Again, a great number of former La Salle players here with Kaya, with the likes of Navaja, Palacios, to name a few. There's also the likes of Dimaandao on the bench. Coach Hans Smith of La Salle did say he's happy to see that some of his players, or his players, are still active. As here's this counter now, Del Campo, but Palacios prevails. Ina Palacios, of course, a tough keeper to beat. Second ball secured by Kaya FC. Kadak just holding a play to get it to Lemoran. Rodriguez. The challenge from behind. Referee plays advantage. And there you go. Eventually, there is a set piece in a promising spot to the delight of the Kaya supporters. Rodriguez appearing to be hobbled from that one and is slow to get up. Let's see who'll be up to the challenge in this set piece. Well, there was the challenge from Layakan. The referee opting to play advantage. But after playing advantage, of course. After playing advantage, the referee deemed a free kick it is for Kaya. And this looks like, it looks like we have Kiara Fontanilla tuning in on YouTube of the Filipinas, saying that she has teammates, women's national team teammates, with Kaya and DLSU. So at the end of the day, of course, to our viewers, support local football in Laban, Filipinas. Lemoran drives this, and it was taken up by the wall. Julieza to Beluga, they were trying to reset, but La Salle just getting forward. Lemoran, what a force, playing central midfield in the 4-3-3 of coach Let Dimzon. Not the best of passes there, as Autumn gifted it to Kaya. Rodriguez looking for a teammate, just utilizing all of her experience, of course. Rodriguez, one of the national team mainstays also. Back in the day, we used to see or witness Ina Palacios and Camille Rodriguez face off. Rodriguez, of course, formerly with Ateneo. And gets it back here. The promising 1-2-1. Lustan. But it looks like it is a corner kick. And it was denied by Danioso. Kaya FC saying it is a handball, but the referee, of course, from his vantage point, did say it is a corner kick. Just the second corner of this match so far for Kaya FC Iloilo. And there is Christine Holiazo pictured, set to give us the outswinger, the right-footed delivery. Initially cleared. Lemoran tried to get it into the mix. And here's Haley Long again. She has that license from Coach Lett. At the back covering them, they have the likes of Amita and Peluga. But Layakan gets this and got to read the passing lane well. The direct ball, but it's no good. Long triggered it for them now, and here comes Lustan. De Los Reyes. Definitely some back and forth action here. This match poised to give us a promising finish. Rodriguez switching up wings now. Playing on the right earlier and is now on the left. Let's see how this will throw off the La Salle defense. And manages to get it. And it looks like we have a penalty. Referee KB Nanyola pointing to the spot after Rodriguez got decked inside the goalkeeper box. That shift from the right wing and over to the left. Just managing to work wonders for them. But the job is not done if you are Kaya. They have the penalty and now they'll have to convert. There was Rodriguez taking a fall against Bing Humawan. Humawan, of course, has been very busy in this game. One all here. Kaya FC with a penalty kick to take the lead. They trailed 1-0 earlier after Laika Tevez found the back of the net. And it is Hazel Lustan up against Jessica Pido, who will prevail. Kaya winning this golden opportunity after they have been on the attack in this match. Sends it to the bottom corner, 2-1. After that slow start from Kaya, they managed to fight back and put in two unanswered goals in this second half. They scored in the 48th mark, and they find it now here in the 65th minute. Hazel Lustan finding goal number 7 in this campaign at 7 goals in 10 games. This golden boot race, and of course this semi-final heating up. As LaSalle tried to play this one quick, but it looks like the Kaya defense have been able to adjust and have dealt with those long balls from DLSU. That was not the case in the first half, as LaSalle managed to connect. There was Palacios with great feet. Amita. Kadag, finding her college teammate, Lemoran. Just combining, of course. Definitely taking advantage of that chemistry with one another as they try to get this one. Konting banggaan dito. Layakan. Just great dribbling skill there. But numbers not favoring De La Salle University. And the miscue there, letting them down. You want to avoid these unforced errors as they could make you pay the price in the long run, particularly. Or who knows if an unforced error could just gift possession and an attacking opportunity back as Rodriguez gets decked again. She has clearly been marked in this game and is having a word with fourth official Timothy De Castro.
There was the effort of Rosel Mendaño. But one way or another, Kaya have taken the driver's seat in this match. Palacios, clearly out of her box. Here's Long. Long, though, with that pass, just gifting it back to LaSalle, and here's the counter. Beluga there, just changing up the run of Shai Del Campo as Palacios picked it up. Beluga again with that, or playing center back, also capable of playing fullback, as it's secured now by the LaSallians. And they give it now, Toledo contra Long. Looks like there was some pulling there, but Long just securing it with her might. Lemoran. The Kaya midfield just humming like a well-tuned engine. Pretty much everyone in the same page with confidence on the ball, just managing to find one another and execute those plays. LaSalle continuing to stick to that game plan of playing the long ball. It worked out for them in the first half. Let's see how they will respond as Kaya have been able to adjust. As it looks like we have a potential change for Kaya. We'll get to that later on. As Santiago whipped it away or sent it, hoping to spark an attack. But Kaya inside. But this one off target and no good for them. Kadag with the initiative. Trying to launch that one. Unfortunately for Kadag, there was no angle. 9 shots and counting for Kaya. Four of them on target. Iloilo just all over the place as Amita got that. Beluga. So seven in the 70th minute already of this match. Kaya FC Iloilo out to complete this comeback of sorts. They trailed 1-0 at halftime as Laika Tevez of DLSU found the back of the net. But 3 minutes into the second half, Shalakadag found the back of the net as Hazel Lustan drilled a penalty in the 65th minute that Camille Rodriguez won. Mind you, also Rodriguez came up with the assist to find Shalakadag as we have the first change of the game. In comes Megan Alforque. And stepping off is Toledo. First touch of the game there for Alforque. Kaya have yet to make any moves on their chessboard when we refer to substitutions, and they finally do so. It is the substitutions, of course, that could just alter the trajectory of this game. Fresh players, of course, could just change this up. So Haley Long set to resume this and played it back. LaSalle just putting their defensive block there that is ultra-disciplined and ready to pounce on the counter. Long and Beluga exchanging touches. Trying to create a gap in the opposing defense. Rodriguez asking for it. But it looks like Danioso got into the way. But Long again, after a difficult first half, just managed to rise up to the occasion. Rodriguez dispossessed Alforque. Tevez, just confidence with the ball, but gifted it back to Long. Tevez appearing to limp or get hobbled, as we are just witnessing a scramble there. Great decision making from Long just to pull it back. And they switch it up now. Kaya trying to use the space. Ramores. Lostan, will she make it a brace in this game? Lemoran. Kadag. Finding Rodriguez, who makes a run. Rodriguez parin. Just running into traffic. Lemoran again, continuing to be all over the place. What a game she has had as they launch it. The keeper again up to the challenge. Jessica Pido has been tested quite a number of times in this matchup and has been able to prove herself. Rodriguez. Kadag. What a turn now. Three players trying to chase her down. Del Campo. Close to keeping it in, but not quite. And there you go. The first change of the game for Kaya. It is Tanhanko who is coming on. And stepping off, from the looks of it, is Nicole Ramores. So a little over 15 minutes for Tanhanko to make an impact in this game. Now we get to flip the script of sorts. It is Kaya with the advantage. LaSalle again drew first blood in the first half behind Laika Tevez. As Tanhanko gets her first touches of the game. Still keeps it for them though. This will be a throw-in for Kaya from deep. And we are poised, of course, for a close finish. Navaja, but it looks like this one rolled out. Goal kick para sa LaSalle. Although the Asian Games may be done and dusted for the women's national team, you get to catch the members of the Filipinas square off right here again. We have the likes of Ina Palacios, Haley Long, and Camille Rodriguez for Kaya. There is Shai Del Campo for DLSU. And storming forward now. Couldn't get it to Del Campo though, but Alforque has settled into this game, you could say. Julieza. Out Palacios. Will try to initiate. Kaya again scoring a whopping 42 goals in the group stage. That's over the course of 9 games. As they allowed only 6 goals. The best offense in the league and the second best defense. That's good for a goal difference of plus 36. LaSalle not far behind, scoring 30 goals. Third best in the elimination round over the 10-team field. And fourth on defense, letting in 11. As this looping ball is still not secure now, but it's on the ground. We got to see Mendaño take a fall though. Tanhanko, Rodriguez, in the middle. Got to slide it over. Lustan, Navaja, took a shot but was asking for a handball. But that one was blocked nonetheless. LaSalle will try to reset. So again, should we be tied after regulation, we will proceed to extra time, which will consist of two 15-minute halves. Should we be tied after extra time? Tama po yan, may penalty shootout tayo. In the other semifinal, we got to see Manila Digger newcomers take a 4-3 victory on penalties as they finished 0-0 after 120 minutes. And here's Kaya now on the attack. Not on the same page as Rodriguez. But that was a delightful ball. I believe it was from Lustan. And this one, of course, just getting fans to hold on to their seats, whether you're from Kaya or DLSU. Long eventually got this ball to safer territory. Beluga sent it back to Danioso. Layakan. Tevez tried to take it from distance, but it looks like it hit a defender. And Palacios will get this and will kill some time off the clock. Time continues to tick, and it definitely favors Kaya FC Iloilo. But as we saw there, as we see off camera, there is a player down. And it is Christine Julieza who appeared to be down. Also, from the looks of it, getting some reminders from referee KB Nanyola. Of course, with Kaya taking the lead, they do have the option of managing the clock. Palacios covers great distance here, as this is in the mix. Lustan. But it looks like this ball will roll out. LaSalle will get this one back. Santiago. De Los Reyes, the captain. So De LaSalle taking a stop. Taken down the line, but initially intercepted. They couldn't switch it up as it hit a lady archer. Layakan. Still got it, but there was Lemoran, who has just been controlling this midfield as he get it forward. Chance taken off the crossbar again for Kaya. What an effort from Tanhanko. Tanhanko just creating a significant impact as a substitute for Coach Let Dimzon. And a miscue there. Pido got it back into play. Navaja just taking advantage of that miscue. Cuts it back now. And the clearance. So thankfully, if you are LaSalle, they get to weather that storm. LaSalle now trying to secure Danioso, still carrying on that effort, but it is halted in the midfield. Amita, long. Kaya now just taking the cautious approach, given that they have the luxury of time. Well, here's the press from LaSalle. And from the looks of it, they moved Shalakadag to the back, now playing defense. They're trying to find Rodriguez. Got to knock it forward now. But sadly for them, it is offside. One of the few instances here that we have seen the offside flag
So less than 8 minutes until we get additional time in this match. It's a winner-take-all semifinal. Again, the loser will be relegated to the battle for third with Far Eastern University next month. The winner will advance to the final and will square off with Manila Digger. When we look at the squad of Kaya, of course, they are definitely stacked with veterans. De La Salle University, a squad of student athletes who participate in the UAAP. As we have a player being stretched now for Kaya. Kaya in their all black uniforms with yellow trim. La Salle, on the other hand, in their white and green uniforms. And we take a look again at what went on. And from what we are seeing on the camera, we may expect to see some substitutions from Kaya Iloilo. But for the moment, they will be down to 10 men. But over here on the closer end, Kaya will be making another change. So here we go, play resumed. Kaya now relatively defensive, given they have this 2-1 lead. Kadag and Lustan again are the goal scorers for them. Lustan found the back of the net as she converted a penalty. All goals from Kaya coming in the second half. DLSU though, or De La Salle, led at halftime as Laika Tevez found the back of the net in the 19th minute and they took advantage of a Kaya miscue at the back and just sent that ball past and into the back of the net. But here's a chance now, playing Del Campo. Palacios quite off her line, but there is Long. But the ball is still in the danger area. Long, Kailustan. So, kanina po tayo rito, Kaya FC Iloilo o De La Salle? Is it Una Kaya or Animo La Salle? Let us know in the comments as Navaja gets this on the switch. Navaja miskicks it though. Definitely not enough to trouble the keeper. The long ball hoping to trigger it, but superb control from Lemoran. Navaja. Ball was intercepted though. Alforque tried to keep it in, but it went past the sideline as we saw. And here comes that expected substitution. Kaya again, we're playing with 10 players temporarily as Christine Julieza was down. And it is Anaya Soto who checked in, and she is listed as a forward for the squad of Coach Let Dimzon. Navaja couldn't secure. Now here's Del Campo. Just trying to get this forward now. Tevez. Long. And to the delight of the Kaya supporters, it will go back to them. Contrasting tales without a doubt. Time on Kaya's side. But that is definitely not the case for La Salle. Navaja over to Tanhanco. Tanhanco contra Santiago. Santiago got the slide, but here comes Lustan. Now on the further end. An unsuccessful cross though, it was denied. But it's a throw in for Kaya. So earlier we did see La Salle get one hand on the semi or the final ticket, the finals ticket. But this time around, we've swapped places or flipped the script. It is Kaya FC as they have this now, a chance to cut back, but denied by Santiago. But it is a corner kick. So let's see how they will deal with this, given that they have this 2-1 lead. They'll have to be cautious, but an insurance goal will come in handy for Kaya FC. For La Salle again, they have to at least equalize a goal from the Lady Archers. Will potentially set us up for extra time as Rodriguez drives this in. This ball taking a number of bounces. Del Campo sends this to the middle though. And it stays with Iloilo. So this match set to resume with a throw in. About a minute and 30 until we get additional time confirmation in regulation. Long looking for a teammate. Del Campo. It ended up with her Filipinas teammate. Autumn down the line. Lemoran just getting her boot there to poke it away. That ball took some flight and went onto the roof of the bench. And it stays with La Salle, slowly but surely inching forward. Autumn but just gifted it to Lemoran, and they got it over to Tanhanco. It's 2-on-4. It's favoring La Salle. De Los Reyes, a shaky moment there as she sends her apologies. La Salle, a university squad again with student athletes. Kaya FC Iloilo, on the other hand, are a club team. And we see Kaya now getting forward cautiously. And in the case of La Salle, they have their numbers spread out. But it looks like the flag is up here for Tanhanco. It is no good. La Salle, of course, with their numbers spread out. They're ready on the counter. Kaya, though, with a slim lead, are getting forward cautiously in the attack. So 5 minutes of additional time again. And it's all geared up for the finish as DLSU get this now. Alforque. Del Campo couldn't get it though. Rodriguez. Navaja. Trying to just suck the energy away from La Salle, who are desperate to find a goal. Kaya in the driver's seat as they switch it up. Navaja asking for it, and there was Tanhanco also up front. And there's a call here against or going in favor of the Lady Archers. It's a free kick to resume play from the defensive half. So another player down for Kaya. And this, of course, or with this situation, they have the advantage and will try to take some time off the clock. So konting recap lang po, ang goal scorer para sa La Salle ay si Laika Teves, who scored in the 19th minute. Shella Kadag level things in the 48th minute as Hazel Lustan just sent her penalty home in the 65th mark to give them a 2-1 lead where we find ourselves as of now. Two-story teams but only one will advance to the finals in the PFF Women's League 2023. So take your pick now. Whose side are you on? Let us know in the comment section. Here comes Navaja. Cuts it back but couldn't find a teammate. De Los Reyes gets his Tulayakan. But some pressure now from Kadag. Kadag, the team's leading scorer, and is set to finish this game at the back playing defense. And in the box, but it hits the side netting for Iloilo. And that was Anaya Soto working her magic on the right wing. As we've got another change for Kaya, the team in black. And in comes Lizzie Torre, a midfielder. As Hazel Lustan, their maestro in the midfield, is unable to continue and see this one through. But you can argue she did play the 90 minutes, save for additional time. About 2 minutes remaining, or less than 2 minutes remaining. Palacios with the clearance. Who will secure? And for the moment, it is Rodriguez. Maria Lasallian taking a fall and slipping in the process. And it looks like it was Navaja who was booked. First yellow card in this game. Players, of course, have been able to display sportsmanship in this one. It's only now that we are seeing a yellow card. So it's now or never for the Lady Archers. Will they pull this rabbit out of the hat? Autumn whipped it in. Lasalle asking for a foul. It's sent back to its origin. The chance to storm forward, Tanhanco. Some shirt pulling there. Referee plays advantage. Torre. Sent it back to Tanhanco. Seconds away from the fifth and final minute of added time. Let's see what referee KB Nanyola will add on, as we had stoppages in the 5 minutes itself. But that is all under his discretion. So this ball to stick with Iloilo. And Kaya poised to repeat over De La Salle in the elimination round. We got to see Kaya take a 2-1 victory despite being undermanned. La Salle, mind you, of course, are missing a few players due to sickness and injury. But they came close, but this game not yet over. And now past the fifth minute already, as the referee looks at his watch. Del Campo. The loose touch there, letting them down. The referee looking at his watch once more. But what an interception from Amita. And that is the full-time whistle. What an effort from Kaya FC Iloilo to take this come-from-behind victory over the De La Salle University Lady Archers. It was Laika Tevez again with the opener. But goals from Kadag and Lustan were enough for Iloilo to take the victory. Two storied teams, of course, but only one managed to prevail. And don't you forget, we will see you in the finals, which will take place in November 8 right here at the same venue, the Rizal Memorial Stadium in Manila. You gotta love the sportsmanship being displayed by the two teams. At the end, they left it all there on the pitch.
And stand by, folks, of course, as we will take you through the statistics. But there you have it again. It is Kaya FC, Iloilo 2, De La Salle University, De La Salle University 1. But first and foremost, we have the highlights to keep you company. What a match. What a match that lived up to the hype. We got to see like a Tevez drilling goal number 18 in 10 matches. As she is one goal away from Isabella Bandoja, the leader in the Golden Boot race. As we will take you through the highlights in this one. Definitely a plenty from the get-go. There was Shalakada, Kaya's leading scorer, hitting the post. As unfortunate luck just hounded them at first. But long story short, it just proved to be a sign of better things to come. And what a display from Jessica Pedo, who was definitely busy in this game. But here was that golden moment for La Salle. The hard work of Shai Del Campo, just denying that Haley Long clearance. And that just gifted the scoring opportunity for La Salle as they drew first blood in the 19th minute. But here was the shot as they tried to answer back again. Behind Kadag, they sent that ball well over the bar. But Kaya just stepped up and raised their game after conceding the initial goal in this match. Tevez again getting that on target, testing Ina Palacios. But Palacios, the national team goalkeeper, up to the challenge. And there was a challenge from Layakan over to Haley Long, but there was that chance there that did not trouble Pedo at all, who still displayed a great performance for La Salle despite the unfortunate result. If you are La Salle, as we see there, they found the back of the net. If you're La Salle, they can settle for the battle for third, which is a rematch of last season's UAAP. As there's Palacios again, who was kept busy as Kaya were just working forward. But there was the moment that gave them the lead. Hazel Lustan drilling the penalty. That was definitely the final goal of this match, but action was aplenty as Kaya were keen on safely getting forward to attack, but there was also De La Salle who just struggled to respond to the two goals that their rivals put in the second 45. There was a missed kick by Navaja though, but thankfully for them, they got to stay sound on defense. And there's another chance hitting the side netting as we have our numbers right here. And with what we have, of course, Kaya eventually maximizing possession, 60-40 shots, 11-5. They were relatively even in the first half when we look at those numbers, but Kaya just came up with opportunities and got those shots to test the keeper. Offsides, check that, we're at 3, mind you, for Kaya FC Iloilo, with fouls going 6 apiece. We got one card in this game that was given to Irish Navaja from the looks of it, as Iloilo eventually saw this through and sure did give a great test to the youthful De La Salle University Lady Archers, who are using this tournament as part of their build-up for the UAAP, as they are out to bounce back from their second place finish to the Far Eastern University Tamaraos. But mind you, La Salle will have to settle for the battle for third versus FEU. That will be a rematch of collegiate squads or university squads, but over at the finals, the big event on November 8th. It is two giants clubs squaring off for the PFF Women's League title.
Kaya FC Iloilo will face Manila Digger FC as the big dance is set. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. It's Kaya FC Iloilo 2 behind Kadag and Lustan, and De La Salle University 1 behind the first half strike of Laika Tevez. And this was Clara Manzano on call for this match, and thank you so much for joining us in what was definitely an action-packed affair. And thank you very much in behalf of the entire crew, Director Renzi Medina, camera operators James Baldoviso and Paula Tagra. And that will do for now, as we will catch you soon and continue to support local football. Thank you very much. Maraming salamat at magandang gabi.